This is a quick overview on the concept of velocity, which is more or less the same as the concept of derivative, which could be called rate of change in general terms. If you are already acquainted with that, you may want to skip to the quiz. Imagine this situation, that we have a high-speed train on a track that is labeled from minus 100 kilometers to plus 100 kilometers. So the track is 200 kilometers long. And this is our timetable. The train starts here at minus 100 kilometers and drives at a pretty high speed till 1.5 hours after the start. Then it stops at this position, 50 kilometers. It continues somewhat slower for 1 hour till it reaches that position at plus 100 kilometers. Then it immediately returns to the position x equals zero 4 hours after it started. This is, if you will, a mathematical view of the timetable, of the train's timetable. Let's rotate this by 90 degrees to get something that's more typical for physics. So now I've taken this diagram and rotated it by 90 degrees to come up with that diagram. T-axis now points to the right and the x-axis now points upward. Now we can create a second diagram from that that shows the velocity. So here the train advances at 100 kilometers per hour. Here it's just 50 kilometers per hour. Here the train goes backward with 100 kilometers per hour. So maybe a good idea is to label this axis with plus 100 kilometers per hour and minus 100 kilometers per hour. So here we have a velocity of plus 100 kilometers per hour, here too. And then the train stops, which means we have a velocity of zero. And here the train starts again and makes 50 kilometers per hour, which is just half as much as before. And here we are going backward with 100 kilometers per hour as a speed. So the velocity is minus 100 kilometers per hour. This is what the velocity looks like. So if you're going forward, it's positive. If you're going backward, it's negative. So what we see here is the velocity of the train depending on time. That's nothing but the rate of change of the position, which we call x. By how much does x change if a certain amount of time passes? The rate of change would be the ratio. For instance, this ratio, 100 kilometers divided by 1 hour, a velocity of 100 kilometers per hour. And then in this case, the ratio would be 50 kilometers divided by 1 hour, 50 kilometers per hour. So what we are drawing here is the rate of change of the x position, nothing but the velocity. And this is the very same as the derivative. The derivative tells us the local rate of change. Here the derivative is 100 kilometers per hour. Here it's zero. Here it's 50 kilometers per hour. And here it's negative. As the time advances, the x position decreases. A negative derivative, negative velocity, negative rate of change. There's tons of way of writing that. V of t, the velocity depending on t. One way of writing it is dx of t by dt, or x prime of t, or, and this is what the physicists are using, x dot of t. I'm going to stick to that notation. Whenever physicists want to compute the rate of change with respect to time, they put a dot on top of that variable.